My name is Don Arnold. I'm a urologist. I have a fellowship in endourology and robotics, and I work for SIH. We're going to be doing what's called a percutaneous nephrolithotomy. That's a procedure that is performed in patients when they have extremely large kidney stones. Percutaneous nephrolithotomy has several steps. The first step is the patient receives their anesthesia while still on their surgical cart. After the patient receives their general anesthesia, we place a 20 French Foley catheter in the patient in order to drain the bladder. We then place a catheter plug to obstruct the catheter. The patient is then placed in prone jackknife position with split legs. All pressure points are appropriately padded and secured, and we pay careful attention to the pressure on the face, eyes, and neck of the patient. The patient is then secured to the bed appropriately. The patient is then prepped and draped, and that 20 French catheter that was placed, the catheter plug is now removed and drained to a bag. The patient already has a percutaneous nephroureteral stent that was placed by interventional radiology approximately 1 week prior to the procedure. This gives us through and through access. We then perform a scout film in which we take an x-ray of the kidney, the stone, and the nephroureteral stent. We then perform an antegrade nephrostogram in order to identify the anatomical structures that we need to see in performing this procedure. Specifically, we're looking for the opening of the calyx so we know where to place the dilation balloon. After the antegrade nephrostogram is performed and interpreted, we place a straight sensor wire under fluoroscopic guidance through the percutaneous nephroureteral stent down into the bladder. When this is performed, the nephroureteral stent is then removed. Next, a dual lumen is placed, and our second wire is in place, which is a super stiff wire. This is also placed down into the bladder. The previous images are then reviewed, and the dilation balloon is placed just inside the appropriate calyx. Next, we insufflate the balloon to a pressure of 4 and take a fluoroscopic image, and then a pressure of 12 to ensure that we are in correct position. Access sheath is then placed over the balloon, and fluoroscopic images are obtained to ensure that it's in appropriate position. Once it is in the appropriate position, the balloon is then taken down, and a rigid nephroscope is in place via the sheath into the kidney, and we perform the procedure on the kidney stone.